You see a glimmer of hope flicker across Slane's eyes as he notices your approach. It's quickly doused with a practiced scowl of the oft disappointed.
Have you brought it? Or am I to remain a slave?
Slane rears back in eagerness, grasping the purging wand with razor-sharp claws. Before your eyes, the source from within the wand surges into his draconic form, filling him with a light so bright that you must shield your eyes from the glare. The blazing brightness dies down. Squinting, you now see no dragon before you, but the figure of a handsome lizard. A handsome lizard with the same eyes as Slane. His eyes still blaze, a piercing silver. A triumphant smile dominates his face as he bows extravagantly before you.
Slane, at your service. All like me have such eyes. With them, I see spirits. Not a blessing on this haunted island. You are lucky not to see the desperation that lies before me.
He smirks.
I offer my aid to those deserving. You have more than proven yourself as such. But I am no errand boy. And I do not come when called. When you are truly at a loss. When you have no choice but to back down or perish. You will find safety in my shadow. This, I promise. I am a dragon knight, aren't I? We have a knack for knowing.
Slane smiles at you and turns to leave. He takes no more than a few steps before he shimmers out of lizard form, blurring in midair back into a majestic dragon that soars away. You knock hard against the wood, searching for a hollow space or hidden lock. No matter where you look or touch, the door remains stuck.
Thank you.
The cub looks sadder than anything you've ever seen. The cub stifles a sob.
I want my mum. I don't know. The men in red came with their big rolling box thing and she told me to hide. She hasn't come back. Have you seen my mum, mister? Dunno. What's a magister? Oh no. Did the bad people hurt my mum?
The cub looks like it's going to cry again.
Things, I suppose. I'm too young to know about things. If my mum was here, she'd be able to tell you. My mum knows about things. She's just being protective. It's her way. She's a good mum, she is. I want my mum.
The cub's maw quivers.
Don't say that, mister. Don't say that. I'm too young to be without my mum. What'll I do?
The bear gulps. It looks doubtful.
Okay, I guess I'll try. Thanks, mister. I'm gonna go hunt some large animals now and see if I find my mum along the way.
The cub nervously ambles away. A young magister tenderly fingers two fresh gashes across his eyes and face. His fingertips hesitate over his closed eyelids. He's been blinded. At your approach, he spins to face you and readies his shield.
Stop! Stop! Who goes there? Escaped. Hold still. I need to apprehend you.
He sidles blindly beside the cart, groping his way toward you.
I can't let you go. It's my job. It's why I'm here. Don't you understand? You're so dangerous. It isn't your fault, but you are. If you leave this place, you could bring a Voidwoken on your head at any time.
He continues to grope toward you, his sword clenched tightly in his hand. He opens his eyes a fraction of an inch and winces, stumbling over a rock stuck in the mud. He clings tightly to your forearm, getting his bearings on the marshy ground.
How bad is it?
He stands there for a moment, very still, holding on to you. His grip on you tightens before he lets go and stands at his full height.
Look! Look! I have a job here. I need to guard this cart, and more than that, I need to protect people. You and the people out there, I can't let you leave.
He pulls a pair of shackles out of his bag and holds them out, open toward you.
Nothing! Understand? Stay away! Please, don't make this any harder. You're dangerous, I need to keep you safe. I need to keep everyone else safe. Have you seen a Voidwoken? Have you? They come in the night. They come by morning. They kill everyone. I've seen it. I won't let it happen again. Hold still. Please. Please. Oh, come here.
Yield to none.
What is this? Some sort of magister weapon?
The keening cub looks sadder than anything you've ever seen. Then the cub looks up at you with a sad expression.